Yeah. Hey, you know what?
Thank you.
Thank you. $20, so I will give you $20 for your shirt, as well as $30 for being such a good sport. Now that is $50, so what do you say? Will you take the money?
Yeah.
Or would you rather open the box?
What's the
And that just goes to show you the difference between our sense of humour and the rest of the world. And now, sensation seekers, it is novelty time. But we have been very fortunate enough to secure an appearance on our stage by one of the only remaining truly genuine bearded ladies in the civilized world, and New Jersey as well. She is, in fact, one of only two bearded ladies currently appearing on stages west of the Urals. So please put your hands together. Give a nice, warm Philadelphia welcome for Mademoiselle Latouche!
I am always so very, very happy. I am always so full of happiness.
Now, mademoiselle, I must ask you a question I'm sure all our sensation seekers here tonight are wondering, and that is your beard in fact truly genuine?
Girls, mon ami, my beard is perfectly genuine.
Yes, but should there be any doubting Thomas is here tonight, would you be so gracious as to pass through the audience allowing the sensation seekers to inspect your beard?
Girls, mon ami.
Isn't she lovely?
Thank you. hard, but I mean.
You don't know where he's been. Please, back up on stage, mademoiselle. Now, mademoiselle, I believe you have a very special secret you'd like to share with us tonight. Is that correct?
That's correct, Oscar.
Yes, Mr. Kitzinger. Incredible as it may seem, Mademoiselle Latouche is not a mademoiselle at all. She is, in fact, a madam. Yes, you were recently married, were you not, mademoiselle? And your husband is here with us tonight.
That is correct, Oscar.
Yes, here he is, sensation seekers. The husband of Mademoiselle Latouche, Hamlet McWilber! Some of the more sensational moments of your recent marriage. Would you please kneel? Do you hand me more bag and take Mademoiselle Latouche to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do, yes!
And do you, Mademoiselle Latouche, take Hamlet McWallbanger to be your awfully wedded husband?
I do, please!
Do you have the nail, please?
Yes, sensation seekers, I hold in my hand a perfectly genuine 3-inch stainless steel nail. I shall now pass to the audience, allowing some of the sensation seekers to inspect the nail. Ah, you, sir, is that nail real? The gentleman says, yes. And now, second opinion from a lovely lady, is that nail real, my dear? Yes, it appears to be so. She strokes it beautifully. And now, sensation seekers, keep your eyes on this nail at all times, as I shall now dip the nail into this bottle of antiseptic Listerine, thus sterilizing the nail completely. I now wipe the nail clean with these two cotton balls. The balls for your inspection, sir. I now pass the nail to Hamlet McWallbanger, and of course the hammer.
Now repeat after me, with this nail I be wet.
With this nail on
the way. I need manage like a hole in the head. And now, sensation seekers, the great Hamlet McWallbanger driving a 3-inch nail deep into his face. Any moment now, the nail should be passing through the membrane.
Yeah.
Passing through the membrane now, and if you're already quiet and listen very carefully, you will hear the crack as it pierces the membrane and hits the bone. Absolutely incredible!
Something more suitable.
Yes.
I hope your screwing is as good as your
nailing. There she goes, sensation seekers. Very beautiful. And now, Hamlet, if you please pass to the audience, allowing the sensation seekers to inspect the nail up your nose.
Alison, place both hands out, palms up. There you go. Now, close your eyes, Alison. Sensation seekers, I hold in my left hand a cigarette lighter, and in my right hand I hold a 10-cent coin. I shall now place the cigarette lighter on Alison's left hand, and the 10-cent coin on her right. I now switch them over. I now switch them back. Now, Alison, please hand me the heavier object. No, Alison, that's the lighter! Sparks between us, Alison. No, you keep that. That's the type of bloke I am. Now that you're making twice as much as I am, let's have you over here. You're on the payroll now, Alison. I chose you because you have a wonderful imagination. I saw who you came in with. It's not that funny, all right? All right, here we go, Alison. I'm showing you the world's only invisible deck of cards. Have you ever seen that? Good answer. Now, I want you to shuffle those up. Go on, shuffle them up. There you go. No, take them out of the box. So that wasn't funny at all, was it? All right. Here we go. Shuffle them up. Take one out that you like. Look at it. Don't show it to me. That's... You got it? Okay. Now, I want you to place that card upside down in the deck. Upside down. Now, slide the card right back into the box. Now, throw the box at my head. Here they are. No, it wasn't badness at all. I slipped them out of my pocket. Now, the actual badness thing is Alison looked at an invisible deck of cards, and she memorized one of the cards in the deck, right? And would you please announce so the back row can hear you what that card was?
Ace of Spades.
Did you hear that? The Queen of Hearts. No. I'm sorry, what was it? The Ace of Spades?
Yeah.
Are you sure? You don't want to change it?
No.
All right. Ace of Queen of Hearts. Now, wait, hang on. The Ace of Spades. The amazing thing is it in the deck? I don't hear any laughter. All I hear is drums. All right, we'll get it. All right. The Ace of Spades. I asked Alison to place it upside down. Does she follow directions? Let's see. Well, there's the Queen of Hearts.
There's one card, as I've told you.
There's only one card. Is that the actual Ace of Spades? Show it to them, Alison. They don't believe you.
To come along and turn me on. Would you like to get to know me? To touch me? I bet you would. Why don't you pick me up? Go ahead. Don't be shy. Oh, such strong hands. Such a masculine touch. I bet those hands have really been around. Why don't you hold me up a little higher?
Yeah, all right.
Ooh, what beautiful eyes. What a power chin. And those full, sensual lips. Would you like to kiss me?
Kiss you? Don't be silly, all right.
I mean, you're not.
Yeah, all right.
Put out the lips.
Do what?
The lips. There, in the paper bag. Put them on the spot marked X.
X marked on spot!
Now kiss me, you fool. Again, this time. A la Francais? provisions.
No, what?
Champagne.
Champagne? Gee, sorry, I don't have any champagne. Do I?
I do. It's in the paper bag. Pour me, darling.
What, in another hole?
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, the bubbles just make my body tingle all over. I'm starting to feel terribly naughty now. Dance with me?
Yes.
La, 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 la. Would you like to see what I look like underneath?
Oh, yes, I would.
Then just onto my snaps. Now, slip off my cover. Now pour it on me and rub me all over.
Oh, that's wonderful! Take my body enough!
What? Treat me well! Oh, yes! Oh, quick! In the bag! Get out the way!
Yeah!
You tiger! Oh, yes! Harder! Oh, quick! You call 3 seconds good? I've seen cornflakes stay stiffer longer. But I thought you were a real man. What a waste of good champagne. Look, why don't you just turn me off and get lost? Hello, handsome.
Talk later. Shut up.
All right, now. You're sitting in the place, you know.
Your head in the following manner.
I'll finish it now.
Come back! Ah, tear, tap! now, wasn't it? Over! Stop the smirking!
Shut up!
Is it my cow?
Sit down, please.
They're milk for people, not you.
So we're going to have a little semi, little semi, that's good, semi-circle. Very good, very good. You'll be done, you.
There we go.
Very well done.
Okay, shall we do some Christmas carols while we're here?
Now listen to me. Before we go any further, I'd just like to say a few words about getting here. Wasn't very good now, was it? I distinctly remember telling you to follow me holding hands at the double time. And you all took off like an herd of bleeding buffalo. In fact, I would like to say this about the whole bloody operation. In all my years of handling crowd control at the London Metropolitan Police Force, I have never seen such a fucking shambles in all my life! But we're gonna make that right now, aren't we? We are gonna make that right with a little bit of running on the spot! Are you ready? Running on the spot! Lift them up! Running on the spot! Running on the spot! Running on the spot!
We must
improve the bust! We must improve the bust! Stop it!
Ladies and gentlemen, this woman right here receiving immediate bust improvement, give her a hand!
Welcome to you and your new two friends. Now, should we have a bigger crowd than we have tonight, perhaps there would be a second row. And perhaps that second row would not be able to see because of the big heads in front of them. So we have a remedy for that. We call it crouching. For those of you who don't know how to crouch, I shall demonstrate. You take your right hand and your left hand, put them on your hips, bend your knees like this. First row, crouching down. Crouching, crouching, very good. Crouching, good, crouching, good, 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 good.
First row, not the back, ma'am.
Operation in correct sound.
Boing.
Right then, I've just had a word with Mr. McWallbanger, and it does seem that weather conditions are permitting here in the parking lot, so he will set fire to his own head. Yay! Mr. McWallbanger, sir, will you please take up the premier lighting position? Now then, the constable is displaying the first piece of equipment. This is the neck piece. The neck piece is then placed over the McWallbanger neck. Well placed, Constable.
Hang it up.
Next is the booster shot of fuel. Booster shot of petrol coming right up.
Oh, yeah. Oh. Is it leaded?
Only the best for you, Hammy. Now then, the second piece of equipment is the chimney piece. Constable is displaying the second piece of equipment. The chimney piece is then placed over the McWallbanger head. Well placed, Constable. Now then, Mr. McWallbanger, will you please inform us when you would like your head set alight?
Company, attention! Chap! Bugle up, sound the colours! Three steps forward and a column of two! Set torches! 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1.
Two steps forward! Left wheel!
Light fire to head! And your own time!
Hair burning, sir.
There you have it, Sensation Seekers, burning beautifully on this lovely, snowy Philadelphia evening. I hope you brought enough for everyone. Yes, thought so. Now then,
Mr. McWallbanger, would you please inform us when you would like to have your head put out?
Can I have my head put out now, please?
The constable is now displaying the regulation dowsing equipment. This dowsing equipment is then placed atop the McWallbanger cranium, thus putting out the flames. Yes, we've had Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, and now Hamlet McWallbanger! And now, gentles, the human bomb. The constable is displaying tonight's bomb. This bomb is similar to those being used in public buildings and mailboxes throughout the civilized world, and New Jersey as well. Now then, Mr. McWallbanger, would you please assume the premier bomb position? Big Wallbanger doing his warming up exercises.
So cold.
Now then, the bomb is placed atop the McWallbanger Tom. And now, the human bomb. Constable, the protective eye goggles, please.
Get us out! Goggles on, it's up!
And now, the human bomb. You know, it was this very stunt that gave Dick Dobley, that other famous stuntman, the hernia that was to plague him for the rest of his life. The human bomb. In fact, after his last lower torso explosion, he commented, well, the blacker the knacker, the sweeter the meat. Yes, of course. The human bomb.
It's lit!
A drink for the star, please! Oh! Fire drill, constable.
Don't need a panic, sir. I gotta come out.
All right, here we go. Move! Road man shagging the fire. Let him through here. He's a bit woozy. There he goes. Look out. Hammy, the theater's this way, sir. This way is the theater. The back door is to your right, sir. There he goes. Hammy, you didn't park your car here. Go. There he goes. The stunt man. Sorry, no. Don't give it to him. He'll confuse him. He'll come back. And now, sensation seekers, we go back to the theater, which, by the way, is right here, where I will have a dry martini and you will have a brief intermission. Dismissed! Yeah.
Thank you.
gunslinging machine. Lip and clip.
Thank you. I got no.
Bye.
in position with that Stanley tape held firmly between his knees, his nimble fingers on that Stanley tape, and gripping with the left and teasing with the right, and he's away. That's bigger than me. And now what's on his own car worries? He's looking for two sets of couples or sensation singers to be tonight's Stanley competition contestants. Marcel, how you doing out there? Here we go, our first couple right there. It's Burke and Flo. Give him a hand, sensation singers. The lovely Burke and Flo. He is a firecracker in the goggles, and she is a rocket scientist. Well, she can him. Who knows? There you go, Burke. And you sit in that chair right there. Flo, you stand right there. Flo, you sit there. No, Burke, you're over there. Wait, no, Burke. Place your Stanleys firmly between your knees with a little flange sticking out like you saw Marcel do earlier. Excellent work. Now, chaps, both hands behind your head. There you go. Keep them, both hands. There you go. Just like that. Until the end of the game, you mustn't move them. All right. Now, ladies, Flo, Ethel, girls, would you please grip the tops of the Stanleys using the forefinger and thumb of each hand. And there you go. Both hands, Ethel, like you do at home, love. Oh. All right, girls. Now, when I say go, I want you to start teasing those Stanleys out and up, and the couple with the highest Stanley at the moment will be tonight's Stanley competition winners. Yes, Marcel's giving me the slow finger. That's for you, girls. Slower is better. You've been telling us this for years, so show us. By teasing those Stanleys out and up ever so slowly, the slower you go, the better we feel, and that's the end of that. Okay, now then, blokes, very important for you is the little yellow knob between your knees. That's the Stanley brake system. At the moment, your Stanley wilts. We want you to hit that brake button immediately, otherwise that Stanley comes whipping back and does serious damage to your unspeakables. All right, how many sensation seekers think that Fred and Ethel will win? Oh, a few of them had an afterthought that they forgot they were watching the show. And how many think that Bert and Flo will win? Naughty couple, yes. Always the kinky ones comes out on Friday. All right, Fred and Ethel, are you ready?
Ready.
Okay, Bert and Flo, are you ready?
Ready.
Orchestra, are you ready? All right. Sensation singers, are you ready? Lots of cheer. All right. Here we go. On three. One, two, three. Go. Inches left.
Oh, 85!
85 inches, sorry! Good one. All right, take off your name tags. You'll be giving them back to us. Marcel, and Bert and Flo, you stay right there. We have a wonderful prize for you, and you two, the lovely and not quite couple, stay right there, because even though you didn't quite win, we don't have any losers on our show, Rules of the Game. It doesn't want you to go home empty-handed, so Marcel, tell us what we have for our losers!
That's right, friend, nothing. You shan't be going home empty-handed because you have got the news. It does the art, ecologically friendly, gloriously vaporized, energy blender! Now you can whip, twirl, curly, or even mix your favorite culinary concoctions whilst exercising those ever-important wrist muscles at the same time. All yours from your friends at the Madhouse Cafe.
Because they get the Rules of the Game Go Home Stanley Starter Kit, which we welcome. That'll make you the only one in the neighborhood sensation seekers. And you come to the area personalized instruction manual. Plus, you get three sets of two tickets each to this show. You can use one to watch the rest of it tonight. Give them a hand. Well, I'm it for an after. Excellent work there. Oh, I'm going to miss those kids. Keep your eye on that, way. You're having a relationship with that, aren't you? And now, Sensation Seekers, tonight is a very special night for us because tonight is the night that Hamlet the Clawbanger is celebrating the 10th anniversary of the night he went out of his mind. And here,
with the kind of act that many people firmly believe will one day replace entertainment, I give you the master of the mystical arts. Now you see him, now you wish you didn't. Hamlet the Clawbanger!
Thank you. Thank you.
scene as we come to the climax of our show is once again I present the wonderful Hamlet McWallbanger and the legendary Berlin mailbag escape. Ow! And here we have the equipment. We feature here one 12-foot length of the stainless steel chain to encircle the McWallbanger body. Also one 12-inch length of the stainless steel chain with a heavy-duty padlock to secure his ankle. One single padlock to secure the various chain lock points. A pair of authentic London Metropolitan handcuffs for the securing of the wrists. And finally, a 12-inch stainless steel bar with two padlocks to secure the top of the mailbag, all modeled beautifully by myself. Now, Mr. McDormand is most anxious that none of you here tonight think that any of this equipment is in any way tricked or rigged, and he will therefore pass out amongst you, allowing you to inspect each and every piece of his equipment. But first, I shall secure his wrists with the handcuffs. Sir, or any keys, bent pins, hacksaw blades, or any other devices that may aid you in your escape attempt. Off he goes. Now, back on stage, you'll notice Marcel is modeling the chain. Please note that Marcel is topless for your titillation tonight. And here we have the chain. Marcel, we will ask a gentleman in the audience to inspect that chain for any weak links. And now, Marcel, will you please pass out the 12-inch stainless steel chain, the 12-inch bar, and the other areas as well. If you are chosen to inspect a piece of equipment, do so thoroughly because you are the credibility of this entire stunt. Here's the mailbag. We'll place that over here for now. And the stool should be placed. Set the stage for the stunt artist. Hamlet, can you have me back on stage if you can tear yourself away? Come on, Hamlet. Today, please. Here he comes. Must have made a friend back there. You've been inside there, have you? All right, now then. Marcel, will you please get us the 12-foot length of chain? 12-foot length, no, check that. 12-inch length of chain with the heavy-duty padlock. Who has that? We need the sensation seeker as well with that. Please bring that gentleman up with a round of applause, please. He has a long way to come. There, he's unzipping his jacket and he's going to make a costume change for this very amazing part of the show. Here he comes. There he is. He's here. Hello, sir. How are you? Stand right there. Marcel is going to fix the chain around the ankles of the escape artist. Make sure if you can just scoot down a bit. Don't hurt yourself, please. And you will notice that he does so to make a red mark around the ankles. This is showing you it's tight. And then he locks it with a heavy-duty padlock. Is it locked tightly, sir? Please tell us. Oh, very nice. Give the man a hand here. He's wearing the lovely galoshes. You don't see that very often. Very nice. I have to get that pair of myself. All right. Now, Marcel, we do need that 12-foot. Still beer, that's cheating, isn't it? We need the 12-foot length of chain now. We need the 12. Oh, sir, did you inspect that? Were there any weak links? No weak links? Well, very good, sir. Marcel is taking the 12-foot length of chain. He's going to wrap it twice around the McWallbanger ankles. He does that once and twice. After that, he brings it up and he goes around the wrists. He goes around the wrists in reverse figure of eight two times, and then he brings it up and goes around the most delicate part of Mr. McWallbanger's body. His neck. There he goes around once, and he does it again just for luck. And now we need the sensation seeker with the single padlock. Who has the single padlock? Who is? Oh, there she is. Bring her up with a lovely round of applause. She's pretty much on the payroll now. This is her third time up today. It's very nice. How are you tonight? Oh, she's locked it. She's locked it. She's locked it. Okay, that means there should be keys up here. Did those keys fall anywhere? We may have to abort the stunt because, you know, they're here. £5 note for it. £5 note for you. £5 note. Oh, no, that was all trickery. He's out of the cuffs already. You didn't see that, did you? It's called misdirection. Right, here's misdirection now, dancing with the star. Chain lock points into one lockable point, which, ma'am, could you squat down there and make sure this is being done on the up and up? Thank you very much. Is that locked tightly, please? And it is done. Is it locked? There it is. All right, please give her a hand. I love that. And now, Marcel is going to show you the mailbag. You'll see the inside of the mailbag. bag first. Not just no tears, no rents, no escape panels. And then head from the ground, you'll see the outside of the bag. You'll notice again, no rents, no tears, no escape panels. It's a perfectly legitimate mailbag gathered around here at the ankles. Will you please, Marcel? He's gathering the mailbag.
Sitting on.
Please watch very carefully that Marcel doesn't slip in anything from behind. And now we need the sensation seeker who has a 12-inch steel bar with two padlocks. Who has that piece of equipment? Bring him up with a round of applause, please. Ladies over here, you go on that side. I'll take the two locks. There he goes. No, very nice. Fred, I believe, right? Long time, Fred. Still feeling a little... Fred, you're going to thread that through the loops at the top. There you go. And then lock one of them on the one side and the other on the other side. Make sure they're locked tightly, please, if you will. Yes, he does a bit, doesn't he? There he goes. And he's done it. Give him a hand, please. There he goes. Lovely. Now, what you just saw was the Warbine ankles done up with the 12-inch chain with a heavy-duty padlock. Then the 12-foot length of chain went around the ankles, also the 12-foot length of chain went around the wrists, which were also done up with the London Metropolitan Police handcuffs. And then the top of the mailbag was secured with the 12-inch steel bar and the two padlocks. Tough call. But it did steal some earlier, remember that. Now then, Mr. McWarbine, sir, how long will it take you to escape tonight?
30 seconds.
This is incredible sensation seeker, because the current world record, bless you, is 38.4 seconds, which was of course set by the famous Swedish escapologist Bo Aslock at the 1964 Mexico Olympics. Mr. McWarbine, what method, sir, will you be using tonight?
The Himalayan method!
Oh, yes. The Himalayan method. Mr. McWarbine, recently spending 6 months or so in the Himalayan mountains studying this little-known method with gurus of Far East escapology. Yes. Seminar on that later. Mr. McWarbine, sir, are you ready?
Yes!
All right, 30 seconds on the clock, starting now!
Irish labourer for his amusement.
more, and I was wondering if your new piece of stunt equipment was ready for its stage debut.
Oh, geez, Oscar, you know what? I'm gonna have to tell you that it is!
Oh!
If you give me a hand, we'll bring it all up here!
Let me do something.
Just in case it comes back here.
Gosh, they've got the bag. Last exercise.
a thing of the future, lad. Don't be laughing at it. There we go. Don't worry about the hose in the middle now. He's not that heavy. I don't think he gets fit through anyway. Oh, oh, lady in the back there. You might want to be closing your legs. You'll get a rocket in your pocket.
Oh, you're a bad kid.
Ha.
Oh, dear. What are you aiming for?
I'm aiming for that little hole up there in the ceiling.
All right, here we go then.
I've been waiting for this all my life. Here we go, Oscar. The quick burn fuels mechanism. 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 The quick burn fuels mechanism.